Well, I'm hoping for the wide one. And, I just want to see if it'll even sit on top of the fret and clear the fretboard. And it appears that it does. So I'll do my best to put the tops back on all these frets. It needs that. Otherwise, what's the point? Next, let's look down into the Gucci. Okay, so we got apparently non-original pick guard. Apparently original pickups, but we haven't looked under there. The neck straightness, I just put the straight edge on it. It seems relatively straight, but we do not know if that actually works, so we need to determine that. And then we get down into what the hell happened here. So we're thinking, we don't like this kind. I don't know why they would have, they routed the guitar. We're thinking that if it was a solid color, this is a refin, by the way, if it was a solid color, you could fill that, respray the guitar, you'd never know it was there. But because of the refin, we can't do that. So I'm going to take this off. We're going to do a little bit of measuring, and we believe that a real badass 2, which is like on a Geddy Lee model, will fit on this guitar and cover this shit, and you know, we'll fill that underneath, and you'll never see any of that because the bridge will be over top of that. That's the plan. Stay tuned, folks. Like I said, I still, before we even dick with that, make sure that works. And maybe take a peek at the electronics and tell my good friend that owns it that, you know, I don't know what kind of budget he's on, but if you want to make it right, it's going to take a little bit of work and have to spend some money. But that's, if anybody else has another solution to filling up where they routed out the body of the guitar, it looks like they routed it with a fucking spoon to boot. And yeah, so next time, cheers, folks. Well, this is turning into a feature film because, okay, I just plugged it in. Front pickup. Something ain't right. Oh my goodness. See, it just gets better and better, don't it? Okay, the big reveal. This will be fun. You never know. A big rat might jump out. Oh goodness. Well, okay. Aside from the fact that some unbelievable, fucking terrible, I'm not even sure if that's like flux or crud or corrosion, but like when the output jack's all green like that, you can pretty much bet that's the business there. Now, I don't know, like, I'm told these are original pickups. Maybe they got pulled out and looked at, but I don't remember those wires looking like that on my 72 Jazz Bass. Nor did the capacitor look like, so this has been definitely jigged. And one thing I do hate, I don't hate it, but they rely on this plate to ground, to connect ground to all the pots, and also to actually to that, and it's not the greatest idea. You can, for 3 cents a wire, you can make sure they're all properly grounded. So I'm just looking, where's the bridge crown? That must be the bridge crown. comes to there, and they ground, there's a brass plate down here, they've grounded to that, and then that comes up and gets grounded to the controls, and then that, there's better ways to do it. But anyhow, I'll try cleaning that up and see what happens.
Welcome
back
to yet another fun and fine adventure in the degoochery of guitar after guitar. So, just had a quick chat. My friend that owns it, you know, we're definitely under the impression that these got to go. He's got a line on a set of vintage aged replacements that'll go right in there, and everyone will be happy, provided nobody stripped all these screws. No, those look okay. Let's. That came out really easy. Where's that other one that I use for this? There we go. And the whole thing doesn't fall down on the table. So this is definitely worth, you know, fixing up. Like I said, I'm going to do my best to try and revive the frets. When you see that, something happened. There. Because those are plated screws, and something happened. The rust bunny got it. All right. So we see here, there was some markings in the pocket, and very faintly, I got to get the magnifier and I'll put it close to the camera so you can look. Very faintly, you can just sort of make out the end stamp. Put some light in there. The end stamp where it says 72. Okay, enough fooling around. Get rid of this. Let's see if the truss rod yellow works. Ho-dee-do-dee-do-dee-do. First we put straight edge on again. Oh, God. Say we got a new back. Can you, you know, can you donate a new back to somebody? Can you do that? Well, that's, you know, that's looking damn fine. But I didn't see it with strings on it. Apparently it had strings on it. They came off before I got it. So the first thing we want to do, get you in the movie here. First thing we want to do, if you want to check if a truss rod works, don't check it by trying to tighten it. Check it by trying to relax it. So that is really loose and smooth, and it's almost, I'm just going to release it altogether. And if you wanted, you could put a little lube on that nut, but it's not critical. It seems to turn fine. So, and that's, there, we just got snug. And ideally, for a one-way truss rod, that's pretty much what you want. So we're going to put a little bit of tension on it. It's the next knot is quite as straight as it was. I'll go 3/8 of a turn. And that's straightened right out. Now I'm going to try and put it into a little bit of a back bow just to see if it actually, it seems to turn in tension. Nice and smooth. Yeah, so there, no worries. So what we're gonna do is relax that back off back off. I gotta make this really nice and straight because we're gonna fix up these fucked up frets. What do we got there? Just snug, possibly. Well, it's actually good. Take it right off again for a second. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm not speaking up. I'm going to release it again for a second. That's looking pretty sporty. There's just a little bit of tension on it, and it seems to be doing what it's doing. So, I get a hold of Nick and let him know that at least that works. So you've seen this at home before. I just rat-tail the file the shit out of that, and especially the barrel, because that's an open hole, right? So all kinds of shit can fall in there. Grind the fuck out of it. And if that don't do it, a lot of guys will think, yeah, you see all the crud that just fell off onto the rag. And it still looks like it's the this is all full of shit. Cool. Give it a reach around here. Not that I, not that there's anything wrong with that. Okay, so that thing's off for a minute. We can look at the spoon routing, total freehand. I'm not sure what happened here. But one good thing is there's a remnant of one of the original position holes where the bridge went. So if we fit a badass over this, I've got those, so I'm not going to have to even really fight too much to figure out what position it's supposed to sit in. This is going to be a little shitty to fill, but we'll do our best. And once we install a badass, that'll disappear, and I do believe it'll be a heck of a lot better than that clunk of shit. Anyway, I'm going to stop there. I got to call the guy that owns it, and we're going to talk about it. See how much money he wants to throw at it. I didn't even plug it in to see if the electronics work yet, but I will. We'll get to it. I think I can make it survive. It'll play again. Even if we have to bite the bullet and refret it, I think there's enough there that I can make it work. Okay. Cheers, folks.
Yeah, so once again, here we are on Goat Street. That's not the right noise. It shouldn't do that. So, more bad news. My recommendation. What happened? No idea. My recommendation is to that all goes in the garbage, and we have to figure out if the pickups actually work. And I tried tagging in directly to them, and I didn't get no perquacky, but there's a chance something else is fucked up in this. What a mess. Alrighty. Wish me luck. See you soon. Bye now.
So there's some sort of fucked up mystery going on here, because everybody's got their knickers in a knot, because apparently there's some date code on here that says this is a bot from 1972. Regardless of that, this has been dicked over and resoldered and unsoldered and reconnected. I'm guessing when they did the refinish. And then there's this mess. So back to, you know, and this is, I'm sticking with this. I do not try and reuse this shit. It's been fucked. It's been wrecked. If you want me to fix this, this all gets taken away and we put all new stuff in there. You can put that in a bag and pretend it's worth something. But like that, I'm not, like, is that acid core flux? Acid core plumber solder they used on there that did that? But anyway, I'm going to desolder the pickups from all this mess. And we're going to put some test leads on the pickups and make sure they work, because if they don't work great, then it's not good. And then I guess I could look up what the actual impedance slash resistance of the coils should be. I should remember that. 7.5 k ohms, maybe. I don't know, gonna look it up. My brain's soft. Yeah, that's just hideous. It's gotta be, I don't, maybe, oh wait a minute, forensics tells me that maybe he soldered those with a little torch. I don't know, or it's acid flux, like plumber's flux. And everybody's knickers are in a knot about this unbelievably vintage ruined potentiometer. Original factory wiring is worth it. If the wiring has been tampered with, it's no longer original and it doesn't matter anymore. Remember that one. Okay, because if this wasn't such a mess, I might trust some of this, but I don't care anymore about it. It's garbage. We've got the test leads connected to the pickup. Hardwired to my meter. So first we're going to check the DC resistance. And that sort of tells me that it's open. But we can double check that by doing this. And that pickup is open. Because if the coil was working, you'd hear a beep. One down. I can hook it up to the other test lead. I'll do it anyway. Watch. Okay. Next test. Pickup wired directly via test lead to the amp. That's not encouraging. And no, that pickup, no working. Let's move on to the other.
Okay,
rear pickup, bridge pickup isolated. When I desoldered those wires, some nasty, funky, stinky fucking smell came off there that I have never witnessed in my life of soldering electronics. It was just, it's like a fucking dead body. So anyway, let's see what the back pickup has to say for itself. And, no. No. I'm sorry. No. Negative. This is not right. This is sad.
Yeah.
No.
There's nothing. These don't work at all. That's why it didn't make a sound.
Okay. Well, I gotta sign off here and go be like the you know, it's, I feel like I'm like the emergency room doctor sometimes. It comes out and goes, you know, oh, here, we can stop that. We don't need that. Yes, I'm sorry. So at this point, I think the actual neck plate's probably worth more than anything else here. And, yeah, fun times. Cheers, folks. So, just in case people are thinking I'm a liar, and, you know, the Einstein Club's gonna come out of the fucking closet and beat me up. Okay, so this is an old shitty P-bass set of pickups. Yeah, back to this. Should be about 7 k ohms, 7.5. I think they overwind the
bridge, if I'm not mistaken. So 7.5 k-ohms. P-bass, this guy here, this one's under, because I think a real P-bass pickup is around 10 k-ohm. But you can see, we got 8.83 k-ohms. And let's just hook it up to the amp and I will demonstrate. Feel the noise. There we go. Not a fucking beep. Pickup number two, which seems to make some sort of a fucked up beep, but it's probably just a short. Nah, that's fucked. I rest my case. Anyway, folks, it's been sort of a Megillah of a day. I hate being the bearer of bad news. Today I was that guy. If you are one of my patrons, thank you so much. Patreon, jump in. It can happen. Subscribe, like me on Facebook, thumbs down me on YouTube, and, you know, if you've got some derogatory comment, please, by all means, let the world know how you feel. Cheers, folks.